everyone. Today we are with Wordsworth English Reader, book of class 4. Now today we shall study about the poem Someone Came Knocking. I hope you have read and understood, seen my previous videos and understood the chapters done. Someone came knocking. It raises a curiosity. Who came knocking? What happened? Someone was knocking is fine. What happened the next? What's the next? So let us see what's the next. Before you read, do you feel scared when you are alone? Think about you are all alone at home. Nobody is there. How do you feel? Scared, happy. You tried to play everything, watch TV continuously, enjoy eating, whatever you feel like. You feel freedom, but on the other hand, you feel scared too. डर भी लगता है आपको, कहीं से चोर ना आ जाए, भूत ना आ जाए. Does ghost exist? No. Yet we feel that. We fight fear of darkness. Light चली जाए तो we get scared. All alone. You are alone at home. And there is no light, electricity, current is gone. What will happen? Everywhere is dark. You feel scared. What happens? Thing may change. At such times, does your mind play games with you? Yes, so many things come around. Okay, do you feel any funny sensations? Aapko maza bhi aa raha hota hai? Hai na? Sometimes we are in the mood to play, but when we hear strange sounds, we get scared. Does it happen? Yes, it happens with everybody. When you are alone and you hear some strange noise, you get scared. Okay, but you have to curiosity also to know what's going on, what's the next, who is there. The poem describes one such incident. Incident means a ghatna. Here, the poem begins with the speaker describing the sound of someone knocking at the door. Someone came knocking at my wee. Wee means little, small door. How was the door? Door was little and small. Okay. Someone came knocking at my wee small door. Someone came knocking. I am sure. The poet here is sure that someone is knocking at his small little door. I listened. The poet listened. And after listening, I opened. Do you open the door? No. When you are alone, mama says, don't open the door. There may be a stranger or anybody, whosoever is there. Do not open door for anybody. But the poet here opened the door. I looked to left and right. Where did he look? He looked to left and right. But not there was a string. Not is here. N-O-T. Not means here. Not means nobody, some, no one. Or not there was a string. String means movement. There was no movement. Someone came knocking at my wee small door. Someone came knocking, I'm sure. I listened, I opened, I looked to left and right, but not there was a string. Poet here describes that the poet hears the sound of knocking at the door. He goes to open it and there is no one. Nobody is there. Isn't it scaring to you? Are you afraid of this? Someone was knocking at the door. और जब उसने देखा कोई नहीं है तो it's more scaring. और ज़्यादा डर लग रहा है. But what he sees? In the still dark night, in the motionless dark night. Now here is the nature scene. Poet is describing about nature. In the dark night, only the busy beetle. Only the busy beetles. Yes, beetles. Tap tapping in the wall. That noise the poet was listening. The poet was listening the tapping of the beetles in the wall. Only from the forest the screech owls called. And he could hear the screeches of the owls from the forest. Now there is only the sounds and visions of the night. Beetles tapping, owls screeching. Okay. And only the cricket whistling. What was the cricket doing? Cricket was whistling. Okay. While the raindrops fall, yes, falling raindrops. That sound was whistling. This way, the bird wants to convey the sounds and visions of the night around him. He can clear. He can hear the sounds of beetles in the wall, cricket whistling, and a screech owl singing. Fine. So, I know not who came knocking. The poet could not guess who came knocking at the door. He could guess only who may be. Okay. It was the nature's call to the nature. Because in artificial things, we are so engrossed in artificial things, we have forgot to listen the original things. Who listens the chirping of the birds? Who listens? We just switch on our mobile, YouTube on. We are enjoying the hymns, enjoying bhajans, enjoy chanting, enjoying the songs. Who goes to listen the birds chirping? Who goes to listen the other birds? The poet here conveys that one has to go to the nature and listen the voices, the melodious sounds. The poem is found surrounded by mysterious things around him. That is knocking of the door. What is the knocking of the door here? Is the call of nature to come outside, listen the songs, the noises, the voices of the nature. Humans in their practical life are also bound by the artificial things, by the gadgets, that they have stopped considering the beauty of nature. How beautiful the nature is. What is the sound of the rustling of the leaves? What is the sound of trees? How do they hymn? How do they sing? How do they cry at night? What is the voice of animals and birds? Okay, humming of the bees, buzzing of the bees, humming and whatever. So many things, noises are there that are very pleasant too. But due to these artificial things, we have stopped this. So nature is calling to the poet, listen to us also. Okay, that was the knocking at the door. Who was knocking at the door actually? Actually, it was a nature's call to the poet. Come outside and listen to the music of the nature. The poet here is, so I know not who came knocking at all. But poet could not guess, no one was there. But he could guess only, it was a nature's call to him only to come out and enjoy. The poet here is Walter de la Mare. Okay, read this, understand this. I need to explain it again. I will do it. There are some grammatical errors in the poem that happens in poem. That is called poetic license. Okay, in poem, you are allowed to make mistakes to make the rhythm or intonation. Okay. So, the poem here begins with the speaker describing the sound of knocking at the door. The poet listened the sound and opened the door. He looked left and right, but he did not find anybody here. He could hear only the sounds and vision of the night. Okay. He could hear the sounds of beetles in the wall. He could hear the cricket whistling. And he could hear the screech owl sing. So, he could not find anybody. He found only the nature calling to him outside. Okay? Because today people are busy in their artificial life, materialistic life. They have forgot to enjoy nature. So, nature is welcoming to the poet to enjoy. Come outside and enjoy. This is all about this poem. Thank you. Have a nice time. Do not forget to like, subscribe, and share.